Morning, today is April 1st and it is like 6 in the morning. I can't sleep anymore. I'm too excited. Today is the day of my baby shower. So I wanted to show you the before. This is my before and I feel pretty groggy, but I can't sleep anymore and I'm ready and excited to get ready for the day. So I'm going to take you guys along with me. I took a bath last night. That's why my hair is like crazy. So I am going to go ahead and start my hair, get some breakfast, I'm going to paint my nails, and get ready. All right, so it's been a couple hours. I had some breakfast, actually took another nap on the couch. I did my hair, I painted my nails, so I'll just tell you a little about what I did. My nail polish is by OPI. It's Nicole by OPI, and the color is called Believe It, Do It, and it's just a pretty pink. That was just a little tidbit. I put on my jewelry, these bow earrings. I don't know what they are, but they're from my sister for gifts. I don't know where she got them, but the necklace is by Helzberg Diamonds, and it's not real or anything, but it was about $40. Came with the chain, clear diamonds around the outside, or rhinestones, whatever you want to call them, and then in the center there's like a bluish, tealish stone. Kind of hard to see. For my hair, I use this John Frieda Frizzy's Heat Defeat Protective Styling Spray, and I used a few squirts of that all over. I sectioned it off using my little alligator clips and did my Hot Tools 1-inch curling iron. Love this thing. I've been using it for years. Just took a section of hair, wrapped it around the outside, let it go, and this is what I ended up with. I got this in the Sephora Play Box, and I actually really like it. It's a Living Proof brand full dry volume blast. It says it's instant lasting volume and texture, styling and finishing spray. So I just like it because it makes my curl blast. It's not hairspray, but it doesn't make it crunchy, and it smells really good, and it says it's styling and finishing spray. Like, okay. To prep my face, I washed my face. I used my acne treatment, and then I went in with this Glam Glow brand Glow Starter Mega Illuminating Moisturizer in Nude Glow. So this is a moisturizer, but it's illuminating. It's pretty cool. I actually been liking that because even if I put a mattifying foundation on top, it still just makes my skin look really natural and dewy and glowy. And then I used the Clinique Pep Stark Eye Cream. This stuff's okay. I finished it up today. I was like, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. That one's going to my empties. And then I used the Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer Primer. This is in the smoothing primer, so for smoothing your skin. So that's what I've done so far. I also tweezed a few brow hairs. Huh? Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and start my makeup, and I will show you my outfit and everything. I'm super excited for my shower, hope you can tell. For the foundation, I want to do a concoction because I am going for a specific look, which is no acne, smooth skin, no SPF, high coverage, illuminating glowy, but we're going to be outside, I don't want to look like sweaty. So kind of in between, so I have to do a concoction. Before I do that, I got my beauty blender nice and damp. I feel like that gives the most like flawless application if you don't want cake face. But first, I'm doing the Benefit Erase Paste with my ring finger under my eyes. And this just really covers those dark circles. Do you see the difference? This eye? It's like, whoa. Have not been sleeping too well. Pregnancy is rough. But last night I did, I think I got about 6 hours, which was double or triple what I've been getting. Pathetic, but I don't even have kids yet. Why can't I sleep? Is this that pregnancy insomnia? Okay, so this erase paste actually, the erase paste, this is number 2 medium. It says it's brightening camouflage for eyes and face. So I am going to tap a little bit on these spots that are really dark. You don't need much. Like that one tap is going to cover this entire section of my face. And I just don't want any of this peeking through my foundation. But I don't want to apply too much so that I get cake face. I'm just tapping it in with my finger. Okay, so do you see the difference? This one, this side has the camouflaged. Now I don't even have foundation on yet. And this side does not. So it's just going to help my foundation cover. It's going to help it give me that full coverage. Already much better. And then for foundation, I am using 3 products mixed together. High maintenance, yes, but it works for me. I'm using the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is in the shade 103, Natural Buff. It is oil control with a demi-matte finish for 24 hours. This says medium coverage. I think it does a really good job of coverage. And then it says the texture is air light. And then this one is the CoverFX Custom CoverFX Natural Finish Oil-Free Foundation. So natural finish, this one's more glowy. I'm going to mix the demi matte and the glowy. And then this is in the shade N40. And then I'm also using the CoverFX Custom Cover Drops for higher coverage. These are in the shade G30, just a couple of drops. So I'm going to put some of this on my hand and then get started with the Beauty Blender. Now I'm just bouncing this in. I have a lot more foundation on my hand, so I'll do the other side then, but I wanted to make sure that it worked while the product was nice and wet, and using a wet beauty blender, damp beauty blender should help it cover and blend into my skin more naturally. I put back my hair because I'm going to touch up my ears a little bit and do foundation on them. Careful not to get foundation in my hair. The reason is because you see this ear blends in a little bit. This one is like pink. So, and then I'm taking the foundation down my neck. I don't have to do this every day or anything, but I want to because I'm going to be in a lot of pictures and I want my chest and my neck and everything to match. I want to look flawless in those photos. You always want to make sure you also get right behind the ear, by the hairline back there, so that your neck, your jaw, your chin, everything matches. So this is like a high maintenance foundation routine because I don't do this every day, but I want to look good in the photos, you know? Now I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. This is in light medium. I'm going to do a bit underneath my eyes, and a little bit down my nose with the same beauty blender. I do the nose for brightening, but also because I have some like discoloration stuff on my nose all the time. And it's good. So I'm using the pointed end of the beauty blender, bouncing that in. And then right away, before it dries, I'm going to set it. I'm using the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural in Light Plus on a Jessup tapered highlighter brush. It's just a small tapered brush. Only under the eyes. I'll powder the rest of my face if needed later. I have another product in mind for that, but this will just help that under eye concealer not crease. All right, I'm going to be doing some cream contouring and then powder contouring on top. This is the Tarte The Sculptor in shade 1. It's cream. And I'm going to use an e.l.f. small stipple brush to blend that in. Choosing to layer because we are going to be outside today in the sun, and I just want to make sure that I have something that's going to last. Using my trusty Benefit Hoola bronzer, and this is the It Cosmetics contour brush. It's like a flat line brush. I'll be going right over what I just did with powder and then brushing upwards. Believe it or not, one of my favorite bronzers is this It Cosmetics Ticket to Brazil. It's their Color Icon bronzer. And I'm using the It Cosmetics Heavenly Luxe Radiance one, number 14. And just, it's a very fair bronzer, has a very slight shimmer, so affordable, it's like under $5, and I just think it makes my skin look really nice and glowy, so a little bit under my chin. Okay, so that is it for my contouring. Nothing major, but I think it does make a difference, makes my face look a little bit slimmer. For blush, I wanted something shimmery because I'm going to be in the sunlight and I think it's really pretty when it catches the light. Nothing too crazy. My dress that I'm wearing today is white, but it has like a floral pattern with different pinks in it. So I wanted to pull out something that would pull the pink, which means I wanted to something that matched the blush with my lipstick. So that's why I chose the colors I chose. So I'm layering. I'm using the Balms in Stain blush. This is in the shade Houndstooth. And Houndstooth is like a mauve-y pink. And this is the It Cosmetics highlight brush, but I like it for powder blushes. And these are very long-lasting blushes. The Instain, they really do stain your cheeks. So this is pretty matte, no shimmer. And it just gives a really pretty flush. You can see here, no blush. Blush. Very pretty. And then I'm going to go on top of it with something shimmery. I do like layering because I like blush closer to my nose than I would put something shimmery. Like if I put something shimmery here, it shows all my pores and doesn't look very flattering. But if I wear a matte blush and carry it inwards and then just apply shimmer like over here, it looks really pretty and natural, catches the light just right, but I don't look like a disco ball either. The shimmery blush I'm using is the Too Faced Sweethearts Perfect Flush Blush in the shade Sparkling Bellini. And it is more of a peachy color. But one of the shades in here leans a little bit more pink and it has a little bit of shimmer. So I'm going to use that same brush and just apply that shimmerier, you know what I mean, more shimmery one up here more and not as close to my nose. For highlighter, I decided on something a little bit more natural. This is the Laura Geller Baked Highlighter in French Vanilla. And I'm using the Jessup Tapered Highlighter brush again that I used for my under eye powder. I'm applying that right at the top of the cheekbones. It's just a really pretty natural looking glow. And I've just taken a little bit what's left on the brush towards the tail end of the brow. And then I'm taking what's left on the brush again, not much product, tip of the nose, Cupid's bow. Alright, let's tackle these eyebrows. I'm using the Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil, and this is in the shade 3. I think it's the medium shade. Just doing small strokes, and then I'll brush them out with a spoolie. In the interest of making this video not an hour long, I decided to go ahead and get ahead on one eye, get all done. So, I finished my brows, and then I primed my eye with my MAC Paint Pot, and that was Soft Ochre. Now I'm using the Makeup Geek Shadows. So all the shadows I'm using are from Makeup Geek. This one is Peach Smoothie, and I'm doing that over the crease, in the crease, all over the, and up, almost to the brow. I just feel like this makes the most beautiful transition for everything else. Alright, then I used the Laura Mercier Rose Gold colored Caviar Eye Stick. Just use a little bit of that on the lid. I didn't have to prime my eye, I could have just used this, but just a little bit of that on the lid and blended it in with my finger lightly. I feel like it just makes your shadows like look more vivid and last a little longer. And this one is shimmery, so it's a nice shimmer finish. Alright, and then I used a transition shade, also by Makeup Geek. I mixed two of them. These are Cupcake and Petal Pusher. They're like these two mauve pinks over here. Cupcake and Petal Pusher. And the brush I was just using for the Peach Smoothie is called the Sigma E25 Blending Brush. And then I'm using Cupcake and Petal Pusher on an It Cosmetics brush number 200. It's just a big fluffy shadow brush. And these two shades are just very mauve-y pinky. So I'm using those in the crease. Not taking it up nearly as high as I did the last shade. And then I went in with a crown brush. This one is kind of like a pencil brush, kind of like a crease brush. It's in between. And I used Vanilla Bean and Ice Queen. These two whites here. Basically an off-white and a white. And I used that underneath the brow bone. It came off a little bit more stark white than I wanted, so I actually had to go back into Peach Smoothie and blend out the edges. I'm also using those on the inner corner of the eye for brightness. Since that brow bone's pretty white, I'm just using Peach Smoothie. No additional product on the brush, I'm just kind of blending out the edges to make sure it doesn't look too crazy. And then on the lid, I'm using a Crown C460 brush. It's just a flat eyeshadow brush. and I'm using the shade called Cinderella from Makeup Geek. It is a shimmery light pink. It really comes off not like much powder, much like pink actually. It is definitely shimmery, but as you can see here, it's not super duper metallic, it's not super pigmented, it's just a pretty lid shade. And I'm wearing a lot of color on my lips, so I didn't need anything too bright and colorful. Then in the crease, I am using the It Cosmetics eyeshadow brush. This is the number 201. So it's like a dome, more like pointed. And I'm using Makeup Geek's Makeup Geek's Vintage, Mocha, and Burlesque. So those are a dark brown, Mocha. Vintage is more like a blackberry. And then Burlesque is more like a cranberry. And then I take whatever's on that brush and I brush it off on my hand a little bit. These are intense. So I'm going to draw a V out here. And then once I have most of the product off of the brush, I'm just trying to deposit a lot out here for emphasis on the outer V. Once I've gotten most of the product off the brush, I will go ahead and take it and slide it in the crease once, you know, just to kind of get that crease definition. But really, I want most of the emphasis to be on the outer eye. Then I go in with the previous brushes that I used. This is Cupcake and Petal Pusher, the mauve shades, and I'm blending out the edges. And then once I've done that, I will go back in with Peach Smoothie, the lightest shade, and blend that. Going back in with the lid shade, no additional product on this brush, just brightening that back up after all the blending. So I went high maintenance on the liner, of course. This is a special day. I want to go high maintenance. I also tried to stick to waterproof products. Waterproof because I am a hormonal pregnant lady and I may end up crying. The Cargo Swimmables liner in Pebble Beach. And I'm using this on the tight line. And on the lower rim, I'm using the Tarte Inner Rim Liner, Lights, Camera, Lashes. It's an inner rim brightener, just a nude liner. This one is not waterproof, but I figure it has to be pretty waterproof if they let you put it on your inner rim, or it would just wipe away with your tears, you know, your regular eye juice. That sounds gross. And then on the lower lash line, I'm using a special teal liner. This is Laura Geller's Ink Credible, I-N-K, Credible, waterproof gel eyeliner pencil in the shade Teal Waters. Doing it lightly, right below, like on the lower lashes. And I'm not taking it all the way in. And the reason for this is that I'm wearing a teal necklace and a teal undershirt. My dress is like more low cut, so I have a teal undershirt that's gonna poke through, you know, just at the where my cleavage would be. I cover that up. And for the upper lash line, I wanted to get more warmth into the look so I don't look too berry or like too dramatic. I have a winged thick liner. I don't want to be too dramatic. Okay, I get it, I know. But this is the Stila Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner in the shade Dark Brown. So I chose brown instead of a black liner today. Doing a pretty generous line up here. I just want my eyes to show up in pictures, you know? I don't want to fade into the background. From the front, it's not that dramatic, but you can kind of see it from the side. There's a wing, but it's not super... not like the ones you see on Instagram that could... Then I will curl my lashes. This lash curler, I think it's Tweezerman actually from the drugstore. Then you need some waterproof mascara, of course. Okay, it is time for the lipstick. And the lipstick, of course, I chose today is a liquid lipstick because I don't want to be reapplying it all day. I'm going to be eating and drinking and talking and in photos, and I don't want to have to worry about reapplying it. So, I'm using the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in the shade Mother. How fitting! I just noticed that. That is so funny. Okay, Mother, and it's like a mauve pink.
That is so cute.
It's a brighter pink, but I'm going to put a gloss on top. That will make it not last quite as long. But it might lighten it a little in the center. I'm using one of my favorite glosses. This is Marc Jacobs Allow Me High Shine Lip Lacquer and Enamored. Not trying to get complete coverage on the lips, just mostly on the center so it has some brightness to it and a sheen. And then I want to do a setting spray using the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. Letting that dry down. Oh, I forgot to powder. Well, I guess I'll powder when I get there. Sorry, that's my mirror here. But the powder I'm going to be using today is the It Cosmetics Celebration Foundation Illumination in the shade Light. I like it because it is an illuminating powder, so you don't get that, like, white cake like you put baby powder on your face. It's just like a little bit glowy and subtle. I also thought about using the Hourglass powders, ambient lighting powders, so we'll see. I'll put both in my purse and see which one I end up reaching for, but yeah, I think this is a really fun daytime look. I'm gonna go ahead and get dressed, have my husband take some photos of me. I want to get my bump shot for the week and give you guys a close-up. So this is my dress. It's from Pink Blush Maternity. And there's my dog. We're getting ready to leave, that's why she's got her leash on. But yeah, this is just a 1X Pink Blush Maternity Plus. It's just got a tie, and I wore a little turquoise shirt under it because this can be a little bit revealing, but it's a beautiful, like, 75 degrees and sunny today in Arizona, so I thought I would wear something floral, spring. Yeah, this is it. We're going to go now to the baby shower, and I'll show you guys a little bit of that in a separate vlog. Thanks for watching. Bye.